We're so excited to hang with an award-winning musical artist all the way from Ghana, with millions viewing his anointed videos posted online. It is Joe Metal. Hey, great to have you here today.
Good to be here.
Yeah.
We're so honored to have you.
I'm honored to be here.
You know, we're watching some of your videos online, and I mean, it's hard to hold back the tears because the anointing is so present and
Amen.
God's presence. So
Amen.
Thank you for ushering the gift that God has given you for his glory.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
So you've come a long way, all the way from Ghana.
From Ghana.
Wow.
So tell us a little bit about life growing up.
Life was amazing. I think I had like a really humble beginning where didn't know God. Our family really didn't know much about God, even though we sort of like knew that God existed. Mm-hmm. We didn't really have much of a relationship. And from that point, in terms of even life in itself was really tough. Had finances, everything was in a mess for me until, you know, we sort of like met God. I met God for myself, and then I was like, you know what, I can't keep this good news to myself. Let me share with the family. So dragged my parents into it, dragged the rest of the family, and we're still working on that till now.
Oh, that's beautiful. So tell us about those tribal marks on your face.
So when I was young, I was really sick, like so sick. Medically, I was fine. But it was believed that it was more of a spiritual attack.
Wow.
Over my life and what God wanted to do with me.
Wow.
Growing up. And so, and we believed in those things anyway, because we believe if there's a power of God, then there's a power of the enemy as well.
Right.
And so then, like I said from the beginning, my family didn't really know much of God. So they wanted to find solutions elsewhere.
Mm.
So they tried to get to different fetish, kind of like
spiritual doctors.
Wow. Who said that, you know, I had to be marked because there was a spirit tormenting me, and this spirit would not recognize me the next time it comes. All those weird stuff. And so they marked the face thinking that was going to solve it. But they don't just mark it. When they do that, they put stuff in it. They do all those
really?
Incantations and all those things. And so they did that. It still didn't work anyway.
How old were you?
I was really young. I think I was about 2 or 3.
Oh,
two.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And so it didn't still work anyway until I met Christ and everything got better.
Really? So the markings didn't...
It won't go because it was marked with blades and stuff.
Wow.
So it gets stuck to your skin,
uh-huh.
So it will never go.
Well, now it's your testimony.
It is. So I have proof that wow. I've been saved.
That's incredible. And how old were you when you met Christ?
I was about maybe 9 years old.
Wow.
Between 9 and 10. I was just running around the church and everything, but there was a crusade in my area, and the man of God just said, maybe you may go to church every Sunday, but this is an opportunity not just to go to church, but to know Christ for yourself.
Wow.
He said, I bring this good news to you, the man Jesus. And I felt this, you know, warmth in my spirit. And I just went forward and gave my life to Christ. And since then, my life has never been the same, not knowing that God was even going to use me this much.
Wow. So we're going to talk about your new album, Wind of Revival, and your song that you're going to be singing for us soon,
yes.
Pentecost. When you've been writing these songs that go into this album, how does the Holy Spirit lead you into it?
Wind of Revival was more of an inspiration from the book of Acts. When God was giving me these songs about Acts chapter 2, first of all, about how, you know, the Bible says they were all together in one room, and suddenly there came a sound of like a mighty rush of wind that's, you know, swept off the whole place. And the Bible says that they were filled,
mm-hmm.
you know, with power and all. And in chapter 1, it spoke about how you be filled with power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you be my witnesses in Judea, in Samaria, and other parts of the world. And so during that whole encounter with the book of Acts, when I was reading, God started just laying certain things in my heart about the Spirit and how in this end time is going to cause a revival in the world, a stirring, you know, by the Spirit. We're not just going to be speaking about what the Word stands for, but it's going to be followed by signs and wonders.
Mm-hmm.
And so through that, you know, the songs that are coming. So most of the songs on the album happens to be songs of the Spirit, you know, talks about the Holy Spirit and the works of the Spirit.
Wow.
Excellent.
We love that.
Well, Joe, before we let you go, we'd like to close out with a word of encouragement. Is there something God is maybe laying on your heart that you'd like to share through your story.
And can I add one more twist? You could do a little in English, and one, we love culture, we love every country. You know, we celebrate the world, so if you want to add a little greeting in your native language, shout out to everyone from Ghana or Africa, go for it.
So I just want to share something that, you know, this morning when I woke up in my spirit, I heard that there's a sound of jubilee. It's a season of jubilee. Why a season of jubilee? Because so many things that many have been going through, God is about to turn them for their good. Sometimes we go through so much that we feel like we've been abandoned or left behind. The Bible says in the book of Romans, chapter 8, 28, that it says, all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. And so if you are in that purpose of God, know that that thing that you went through or what you're going through and thinking that is about to break you down or make everything go in the other direction, know that God is using all and he's about to turn it for your good. It was all part of the plan from the beginning. And so know that he's not giving up on you. He's not giving up on you. And God bless you. So I would say Nyami Shirao. In my dialect, it means God bless you. Nyami in Shirao.
Woo! So good. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank
Joe,
you.
Well, we can't let people you know,
thank you.
Leave this interview without hearing you sing, so we've got a special treat.
Let's
Joe
go.
Is going to be singing Pentecost.
Sing the Spirit of the Lord is healing in this place. Yeah. The Spirit of the Lord is healing in this place. Every sickness and disease, the Spirit of the Lord is healing. Disease and sickness is healed in the name of Jesus. Hey, it's healed in the name of Jesus. The Spirit of the Lord is healing in this place. The Spirit of the Lord is healing. The Spirit is healing in this place. Spirit of the Lord is turning it around. So the Spirit of the Lord is healing in this place. The Spirit of the Lord is turning lives around. The Spirit of the Lord is healing in this place. Every sickness and disease is healing in this place. It's healing.